smudge the first time. The folk history of America is the history of its heroes. Big working men like John Henry, Big Bad John. But today I'm going to introduce you a new kind of folk hero. He didn't work in a mine, or a railroad, or any of those strenuous occupations. He worked in a beauty salon, and his name was Bruce. Whatever day in the salon you can see him arrive. He stood 6'6" and weighed 105. He's kind of narrow in the shoulders, narrow in the hips, with a curl in his hair and a smile on his lips. Big Bruce. Big Bad Bruce. No one really knows where Bruce came from. He kind of swished into town and stays all alone. Never says much, kind of quiet and shy, but he spoke at all, it was just to say hi. That's Bruce. Big Bad Bruce. Some say he came from New Orleans, where he had a social group called the Cajun Queens. Some say Hollywood or Beverly Hills, where he got arrested for passing $3 bills. That's Bruce. Big Bad Bruce. Then came the day of that terrible fire. Something went wrong in the number 5 dryer. Into the chaos of that majorly gaze went Big Bad Bruce, just a fan in the flames. Big Bruce. And that fire got worse. Someone heard Brucey cry, "Mercy! I forgot my purse." Into the fire with a squeal and a shout. We waited an hour, but he never came out. Poor Bruce. Poor old Bruce. Where that salon once stood, there's a grocery store, but his name will live forevermore in the annals of time, in the hall of fame. And get a young cat who went down in flames. Big Bruce. Big Bad Bruce. Well, you might say that this has been sort of a fairy tale.